Because I just trail off, there's like no order. So, much like the Resident Evil storyline, I make no sense. But at E3, when I saw Resident Evil 2, I'm like, okay, I don't know if I'm gonna like this. Like, when I saw the trailer, I was kind of like, okay. And I mean, they just showed Leon in the gameplay, so I was kind of like, because he's not one of my favorite characters, so it was just kind of boring to me. And I have to like say right now, the only reason that I might not be on board with this is because of the camera angles. Yes, I am an old lady, and I like my Resident Evils with fixed camera angles, because in the Resident Evil 1 remake, like, you never know what's gonna be like around the corner, and I don't know, it's just something about like the point of view kind of makes it scarier because I don't know. But the new one, maybe it's because like when it's the back view, it's kind of like Resident Evil 4. That's the first thing I think of. It's like it's more actiony. Like even if Resident Evil 2 remake does look kind of creepy, but when you have like the character moving along with your surroundings, like it just kind of like it goes by faster. And like, yeah, sometimes you can't see what's behind you because of that, but at the same time, like, it's more actiony. I don't know how to explain it. It just feels like there's less tension because you're like walking, like, I don't know. I don't know how to explain it. It's just everything's moving by you so fast. But in the camera angle one, it's kind of like you're gonna see yourself on the screen for like, I don't know. I'm just set in my ways, I guess, but I mean, it looks cool, but I'm just kind of worried about like if they're gonna make it like a lot different. And I'm kind of disappointed they didn't show gameplay from Claire's story, because I really like Claire and stuff, like. Because Leon's story, like, I don't know if it's just because I played it so much, because it's a little easier to me, but it's like I'm so bored. I want to see the other one. I want to see what Sherry looks like, and I want to see, like, I don't know. I don't even remember. I don't think they showed Ada. I don't remember, really. But that's the one thing I'm worried about, is the camera angles. But my brother showed me the E3 gameplay demo, and I mean, it looks cool. I mean, it's definitely like it's promising. But the other thing I noticed, I don't know if it was just like the video quality or something, but the music I noticed was very, very like subdued. Like they really toned down the music to make it so like you can't hear it as much as the PS1 version. Because when I play Resident Evil 2 on the PS1, like I said, I like the GameCube music, and I love the Resident Evil 2 music. It just has that, I don't know. I just like the PS1 soundtrack. But like with the remake, like the save room music is one of the most memorable for me, because I mean, it's the same in every area. But I could barely hear the music. I'm sorry, I'm distracted right now. I'm like in a different setting, so I'm sorry if I like sound weird. But I didn't like how the music was kind of toned down. I don't know. But I'm sure that I'll probably buy it, because I mean, I definitely hope that they put out more gameplay, because I want to see like more of Claire's story and maybe the B story with oh crap, Mr. X. But yeah. Oh, that's another thing. Okay, so like I said, I'm very set in my ways, and I know that they changed the outfits a little bit for the Resident Evil 1 remake, but it was close to the first one. But with the Resident Evil 2 remake, like, what the hell? Claire, what happened to you? Like, I'm sorry, I sound so stupid right now, but it's like Claire's outfit is like, I don't know. I read a comment. Like, I don't know. I'm sorry if I'm like invading anyone's privacy, but like I read a comment on the demo saying that Claire looks like she's going out to party, And I'm just like, yes, I agree with that. Like, what did they do? Like, I'm sorry, Claire is like one of those characters where it's like she changes every game. Of course in Resident Evil 2 PS1, she's gonna change from Code Veronica. Like, a movie, I don't know if a lot of people saw Resident Evil Degeneration, but Claire was in that movie, and she looked different. But then in Mercenaries 3D came out like after that, and she looked like better, I guess. I don't know. But now in the Resident Evil 2 remake, she has a totally different outfit. I know I sound really stupid. Like, I'm sorry, but I'm very nitpicky about that, and that probably sounds stupid, but I just don't like the character model changes, I guess, because Leon even kind of looks kind of derpy. But, I mean, I guess it's good to change things, but, like, I hope that there's, like, unlockable outfits. Does that make me weird? Like, I don't know. It's just something about, like, I guess I don't know. I just think it would be cool to see, like, the old clothing. Like, I'm going on about this way too much, and I'm obsessing over it now. But I don't know. It's not that big of a deal, but I'm just kind of like stupid that way. But speaking of Resident Evil, I just want to know, like, what happened to Rebecca? Like, I have the movie Vendetta like checked out of the library for like months because like I don't feel like watching it, and I don't want to return it because I just have to like order it again. But it's like, she was like, she's I'm sorry. She's one of the only characters that wasn't picked up. Billy too. Like, what happened to him? Because I'm always on the fence about getting Resident Evil Zero when I go to like a game store. When I see it, I'm like, oh, do I want to buy it? Because I used to play it when my brother still was at home. And it's like, it was okay, I guess, but it was kind of difficult. Like, it was just kind of confusing to me because it doesn't have any like item boxes, so that kind of like pissed me off. And it's just, I don't know. And having the rifle take up two spaces in your inventory, that was kind of annoying too. But it was an okay game, and Rebecca is one of my favorite characters actually from the Resident Evil series. Like, I sound like a nerd right now, but she is. And it's kind of disappointing to only see her in the prequel and maybe bits and pieces of Chris's story in the first one. Like, I kind of wish that. Like, kind of like how they brought Barry back for Revelations 2. I kind of wish they would bring. Like, don't listen to me if I'm wrong because I'm not in the loop about much of this because I've been busy lately, but like, I don't think Rebecca is in any of like the newer games, and I kind of wish she was. Because I remember when Revelations 2 like first like was announced, I thought that Barry's daughter, I think that's who I never played Revelations 2, so I wouldn't know, but I think the short-haired girl is Barry's daughter, and I thought it was Rebecca, and I'm like, oh my god, they're bringing back the old school characters. But then I was like, wait, no. And I always want to know where Billy is. Like, did he get killed or something? I don't know. I think it would be kind of funny if they brought him back. That would be cool. Like, he could have his own game. Like, A Way Out. Billy Edition. Yeah. This is a really embarrassing podcast. The theme for today is embarrassment. Because in my other podcasts, I was kind of like, oh, I'm new at this. I don't know what to talk about. But now I'm just like, I'm bored. And I keep telling stories that I should have just kept in my head. But, what else from E3? I'm trying to think. Oh, yes, Kingdom Hearts. That's another game that has been on my mind lately. Yes, Kingdom Hearts. Now that's another game with a very long history, and don't worry, I didn't have a phase with that. I didn't have the year of Kingdom Hearts. It's not one of my favorite games, but I still have a lot of good memories. the first Kingdom Hearts that I ever witnessed, my brother is a huge fan. He was playing the second one, I think, on his PS2. And now I inherited those because he got the remaster stuff. So I have all of his old PS2 Kingdom Hearts. And he would play number 2 with Roxas, and I was just, like, obsessed with it. I'm like, oh my god. I think I was, like, in second grade or something when he got that. First or second grade, at least. And I used to, like, during music class, I was like, I wanted to ask my teacher, what instrument do they use in that one town? But I was awkward back then, too, and shy. So I didn't ask. But, like, I just noticed lately that video game music, like, really impacted me as a kid. And I sound so nerdy, like, I'm sorry. But it was just something about that game. Like, you know when you're a kid and you think, like, Sonic is serious and stuff? Like, oh my god, this is so grown up! This Sonic stuff is so grown up! I thought that Kingdom Hearts was grown up, and I'm like, oh my god, these stories are so deep and poetic, but in the meanwhile, Mickey Mouse is, like, laughing. So, I still can't take it seriously when you start a new game and it's going through, like, the TV static and it just goes on Winnie the Pooh. I just lose it. Like, I just lose it even thinking about it. Like, it's so serious, and then it goes to Winnie the Pooh, and I'm just like, oh my god, help. But, yeah, like, I remember the second one the most, and my brother used to have Chain of Memories on the Game Boy. That was the first one he got, actually. I'm probably mistaken, but I'm just gonna say that. But, I played it, and I was just like, oh, this is so good. But I never really went back to it. But, currently, when he showed me the new Kingdom Hearts trailer, I was just, like, screaming on the inside, like, don't make me spend more money! I'm trying to save my money to buy important things, but now you're gonna make me want to buy Kingdom Hearts. Like, when they showed the nobodies, I was just like, oh god, help me. Ugh, I'm sorry, I'm getting way too excited. Okay, but, like, Kingdom Hearts took my heart. When I saw some of those scenes, I was just like, oh my god. So, I'm probably gonna buy it. I'm trying to play through the whole series before it comes out, but it's, like, impossible. But I started number 1, but I'm only at Alice in Wonderland. I don't know if I'm gonna keep up with it, because again, it's not my favorite. And I've had the Sims bug lately. But, yeah. I don't know, I'm just trying to think, like, some things. I just want to keep talking and just off the tracks right now. But yeah, Kingdom Hearts is definitely something that I'm looking forward to. Shenmue. Oh my god, Shenmue. Like, I know I probably